Hello there, YouTube, and welcome to Scotland. We are here on Arthur's seat at the top of the hill to do a video just for you. And you know what? I can't actually do a Scottish accent when I haven't got any like phlegm and water in my throat. But hello, YouTube. Welcome back. My name's Adam and this is Carl. And yes, we are in Edinburgh at the top of Arthur's seat, which is just up there. I'm gonna include a picture and some footage as well so you guys can see it. But the topic for today, while we're in this very windy mountain, is the Holy Triangle. And the Holy Triangle basically builds up of three things that you need to take care of vitally in your life in order to be happy all round. And I don't mean that you be constantly on cloud nine, but life will just go better when you have these three things above. If you rate each one, like they range from, you know, like 1 to 10, like 1 being shit, 10 being like incredible, don't need to worry about it. As long as you have them over like a 7, you should moderately be able to live well. So no more Scottish accent for me. Let's get in the video. So the first one of the Holy Triangle is health. Okay, so basically, if you do not look after your health, this is fairly obvious, but so many people neglect it. If you don't look after your health, you are gonna suffer. Now, the good thing about the Holy Triangle is that each side of the triangle, each corner, integrates with the next one. So from the top, you've got health, you have wealth, and you have relationships, okay? So if you don't look after your health, primarily, you can't work as well, right? Your brain doesn't function as much. Yeah. Therefore, your wealth also suffers because you can't work as much.
Yeah.
And if you are not healthy and feeling good and you have no money, your relationships with your friends, your partner, things like that, they start to fall apart because you can't afford anything. And that makes you feel even worse. Back to health, you can't work even more. You have to take more time off and then your wealth suffers again.
Cool.
So, Carl, I know Carl is better off than me. I think you're probably healthier and wealthier, I think.
I don't know, after we just climbed this mountain.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, you are healthier and you are wealthier than me. So do you want to talk about how the impact of health has benefited you? Like when you're in experience with health,
well,
you are more healthy.
With health, we're talking about physical and mental,
yes,
right?
Yeah.
Because a lot of people think, oh, health, that means physical. That means I need to go to the gym, I need to run, I need to lift weights, so on and so forth. Exactly. Those are things that, of course, we do. We've talked about that. It's a very important thing to us personally. And that helps with everything. But obviously, making sure that you take care of your mental health as well and balancing the two of them. Because if you're not healthy up here, you're not going to be healthy everywhere else. Vice versa. Everywhere else, exactly. Vice versa. But in relation to kind of, what was the other one? Wealth.
Wealth.
Okay. So, in relation to wealth, connecting to the health thing, I work pretty crazy, weird, spread out hours, right? So I could work anything from like very, very, very start of the day all the way to the end. And for me personally, when it comes to health, let's talk about actual health is in fitness.
Yeah.
For me to be able to get through my day and work properly and be able to concentrate and mentally work as well as physically work and run from job to job and place to place, being actually healthy massively helps with that because I can maintain the endurance that I need to get through that day, basically.
Yeah, like energy.
So
energy,
like obviously we're talking about everything being connected, so I feel like if that was lacking it would then in return domino effect obviously the other part of it as well.
Yeah, true.
What's and up? I mean, person running.
So yeah. So for me as well, like when I started this, I wasn't very healthy. Like 3 years ago, we started talking much, and I wasn't very healthy. I was in an okay place up here, enough to sort of be able to help people. But at the same time, my body kind of suffered. I was very thin, didn't really have much going on for me. And now I've kind of beefed up. I've got like a bit of a dad bod coming on. The abs are showing through. But you know what I mean? The fact that I take every day, I take 5 vitamins in the morning. You've seen this. And I take ashwagandha root on the nighttime to increase the energy again for the next day. And since doing that, it's allowed me to create a lot more content and be a lot more precise on camera. I know I just like made a pause there to say precise. It's funny, don't worry about it. But it's made me more precise on camera because my brain works better. I feel better, I have more energy on camera rather than just standing here and be like,
hi, my name's Adam from Thoughts in Motion.
Yeah,
like,
that's right.
Try and
right.
be healthy, guys. Be like, no. In order to live the best life, you need to look after your health.
So our second point is wealth. Our second point of the triangle is wealth.
Yes.
Now, Carl, you have more money than me. Like I said in the introduction.
Just throw it out.
Just
there.
Throw that. Yeah, Carl's rich. Okay.
Right now, yeah, but money. Right now, money goes yeah. up and down.
Money goes so up and down. Right now. But there was the funny thing. Ben Shapiro. If you guys haven't watched Ben Shapiro, he is incredible. You should watch him. Ben Shapiro actually is. During a speech in America, he says that most Americans, if you are in poverty or at, you know, at a low end, low money income for the majority of your life, for all of your life, then you suck with money. And all the crowd are going like, boo, boo, right? And it's
yeah.
like, no, that's true. Like, if you are at the low end of like the money scale for your entire life, then you do suck with money.
Yeah.
So for me personally, this is a random, this is a choice that I made several years ago. So I said that I wasn't going to buy a car or move out for a long time.
Yeah.
And the reason for that was because I had so much that I wanted to do and accomplish.
Yeah.
And I'd seen so many of my friends go out there, they buy a house, they buy a cool car, and they have zero money for anything else. They couldn't afford the camera equipment that we have.
Yeah.
They couldn't afford to go half the places I have.
Yeah.
It's just to, you know, brag a little bit. But you know what I mean? It's because I saved the money. I made the conscious choice to save money rather than spend it. So I think it was Warren Buffett, the billionaire. He's like, yeah, you need to spend what's left after saving. And most people spend before saving. They're like, oh, I want this now, I want this now. And to be fair, like I've said this before, like if you want to save money, you've got to be more money conscious. You've got to, you know, be careful on what you spend. Don't buy Gucci handbags, right? Don't buy expensive shoes that you could easily get replicated somewhere else. Yes, it's nice. Yes, it feels cool. Treat yourself occasionally. But if you actually want to get somewhere in your wealth, in your money standard, your standard of living, then you have to be careful with your money. Like, what do you do to be careful with your money?
So to add to that, my perspective as a self-employed person, I was actually watching an interview recently, which was so true. It was with Nikki Sixx from Motley Crue. And he said from a very, very young age and early stages of the band and things like that, he only, like, say he said a saying, right? He said, for every dollar that he makes, only 60 cents of that is his.
Right.
And that's kind of, if you can take that and apply it, type of thing. So, for me, whatever I make, a percentage of that is mine to spend and do things with. The rest is allocated to everything that you need in life, such as bills, luxuries, whatever it might be, savings, whatever it might be. But it's good to have it that way around, because if you have it the other way around, like you say, when you spend and then save, saving then spending to better yourself, to better your life, to advance in your career, your life as a human being, it's best off that you have it that way around, I would say.
Yeah, and I mean, just as a final point as well, like, in your, like, we are, I'm 23, Carl's 24.
Nelly.
In your, you are 24, aren't you? Shit, did I get that wrong?
Next month.
All right, fuck. Yeah. This is cut. Yeah, so obviously we are in our 20s, like I would say in any mid-20s, and we are slowly progressive. Like, I've got more money now than I ever have, so have you.
Yeah.
And I feel like through the 20s and through the 30s is where you need to make that money.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas everyone sort of out there that I know especially is spending that money faster than they were making it.
Yeah.
And they're in debt, they've got overdraft, blah, 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 whatever else.
True.
And I feel like to have that at such a young age is not the right way to
not
do it.
Setting things up.
I mean, I know sometimes there's right ways and wrong ways to do things, but I think that to have spent all your money in your 20s and 30s and have not hustled to the point where you've got a good income and you can relax at the later parts of your life, then I feel like you've done it the wrong way around. So the final point of the triangle is relationships. Now, we're not just talking about your sexual relationships, we are talking about your social life in general. Now, a lot of people I know, I've seen a lot of statuses, actually, people are starting to get a bit lonely this time of year. I've noticed that a lot of people, you know, especially after Valentine's Day, people kind of felt like, oh, I have no one. But you got to remember that you need to keep in touch with your friends too. So I know it gets harder as you get older, you get busier, but this is a point that you need to pay close attention to, especially if you want to succeed anywhere or you want to have a happy life. You have to have a social circle. It doesn't have to be, you know, 30 people large where you go and you have it in the massive tables and restaurants and stuff like that. It doesn't have to be like that. It could be three or four close friends that you see once a week, twice a week, once every 2 weeks. That kind of social environment will really get you feeling good again, because, like, you know, it's always good to be around people. You don't want to do everything on your own. It's good to have time on your own. It is. But at the same time, you want to be around those people that make you feel good. And I know, Carl, you wanted to bring up the point of negative energy sucking leeches, didn't you?
Yeah. So one thing that I've noticed in life is...
To get deep.
to get deep. Mm. Oh, when the mountains are getting deep. The way I feel is very actually affected by who I'm with and who I'm surrounded with. I've realized this, like, if I'm with someone that's like really confident and positive, like that really does rub off on me, and I feel so much better. And it's so good to be around people like that, because they just help you, they motivate you, they do all of those positive things that you need to succeed. So obviously just being careful and monitoring and making sure you're not around incredibly negative people, and also energy sucking people, positive energy sucking people. And you'll know this, I feel like, I don't know if you've noticed before, but you can kind of feel it. Yeah. Almost it's like a sixth sense type of thing going on. You notice, like, whether you don't notice at first, you might notice later on, but you definitely do notice.
Yeah, and I mean, I know people like that. I hang out with Carl probably the most. I've got my good friends like Connor and Jack, stuff like that. And they keep me sane, they keep me focused and motivated. But to be fair, I think you need to have certain friends for certain different kind of things. So this is another, this is sort of tangent, but I want you to pay close attention to. So for certain things, you need certain friends. So for you, I can confide in you, I work with you, and we go out for beers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I have other friends who I class as more mentor-style friends, where I'll see them less often, but when I do, it's to talk life. It's almost like a therapy session. So I have friends
for
that.
Everyone has a purpose,
Yeah, like, and it's not that you're trying to use these people for a certain thing. You do respect these people, obviously, but they have that certain purpose in your life. And I genuinely, I enjoy hanging out with degenerates, right? I enjoy hanging out with sometimes miserable people, sometimes people who hate life and things like that, because it gives me another sense of perspective, because then I have something to compare all this motivation and positivity to. So when I hang out with them, I don't try and change them, because then they resent you for it. So to round off this video, we have the holy triangle. We have health, we have wealth, we have relationships. Your health is primary focus, guys. You have to look after your health so you can work, so you can make money, and have a social life. If you don't have a social life, your health will suffer. You will start to feel lonely. You will not want to go into work. You will not want to work as hard. You are not as passionate. Therefore, you will not want to even meet people, because your default state will be loneliness. It goes around in a circle for a triangle, okay? It's really strange. It's like the Deathly Hallows symbol. That's kind of how it works, right? That's how it works. So always remember to look after those three in your life. Sometimes you'll diminish from like a 9 out of 10 in one area to like a 5, and that's when you need to focus back on that area. So it's a constant, it's almost like spinning plates, kind of, that's how I imagine it. But as long as you have those three things, you will feel better in your general life. It's subtle, it's incredibly intelligent if you can get your head around the whole, you know, the holy triangle as we call it. But there's many other names for it, the golden circle, you call it other stuff, right? But in truth, look after those three and you will be a lot happier.
So after a lovely, scary, amazing walk up here, we'll put some B-roll in. We're gonna close off this video. Just wanna say, be sure to subscribe. Click that little bell that you see right there so you get notified of all of our upcoming videos. Check out all the previous ones. The website links and everything are down below. And we'll see you in the next video.
Peace.